Hello everyone, how are you all? Myself Nagappa, you are watching Appa Chemistry Classes. Now our today's topic is electrochemical cell. Till now we had seen the electrolytic cells. So what are the, how electrolysis process takes place by passing the electric current, and what type of reactions takes place at cathode and anode we had discussed. And after that we had seen the most important Faraday's first law and second law in part 6 and part 7. Now we are coming to the part 7 of part 8 of electrochemistry. So that is most important, electrochemical cells. So in electrolytic cells, what happens? The electrical energy is converted. It is utilized to produce the chemical reactions at the respective electrodes. But whereas in case of electrochemical cells, the by spontaneous redox reaction, what happens? Electrical energy will be developed. By chemical reactions, electricity will be developed. Such type of cells are said to be what? Electrochemical cells. Now in today's class, we'll have the detailed study about electrochemical cell. For those electrochemical cells, example will be what? A galvanic cell, or you can take it as a Daniell cell and voltaic cell. In our board exam, mostly we will get the what? This name, galvanic cell. In NCERT books, or mostly they will focus on this galvanic cell word only. It is also comes under what? Daniell cell and voltaic cell. So no difference at all. Just I will tell you the difference also. Okay, na? So till now, those who not subscribed, please do subscribe and support the channel. Thank you. Let's get into the video. Now here, electrochemical cell. Now here, the learning of question is very easy, but understanding of concept is very important. So try to understand the concept till the end, and you watch till the end, then you will get the complete picture of electrochemical cell. Now first we are going to see what is mean by electrochemical cell. So say for example, I am taking one electrolytic cell. So in this electrolytic cell, I have taken the copper sulfate solution. So what it is? Copper sulfate solution, aqueous copper sulfate. This aqueous copper sulfate will have the which color? Blue color. Now in this aqueous copper sulfate, what I have done, I placed the one zinc rod. So I had placed the zinc rod. So this is zinc rod. So after some time I observed that. So here what happens, the color of blue color will be there. What are my observation after placing that zinc rod after some time? So slowly the blue color will be fades away. Blue color is what happening? Fades away. That is, blue color is disappearing. Okay, na? And also I found that there is a reduce in size of the zinc rod. There is a reduce in the size of the zinc rod in the electrolytic solution. So the size of the zinc rod will be slightly decreased. So zinc rod size is reduced. Okay. And also after some time I observed that some small precipitates are So that is what brown colored precipitate. So in the bottom of the, that below the rod of the zinc rod, I observed the what? Brown colored some precipitate I observed. Brown colored spots I observed. And also I observed that there is an increase in temperature. Rise in temperature. So temperature will be increases of the electrolytic solution that I observed with the help of thermometer. So this is a thermometer. Consider now here, with this thermometer I observed that there is an increase in temperature. Now what happens actually, the zinc rod is what? It is dissolving in the aqueous solution. That zinc rod react with the sulfate ion and will convert it to what? Zinc sulfate. That is Zn plus 2 will takes place. That is, zinc is undergoing oxidation. And what are the copper ions which are present in the copper sulfate? So these are copper ions which are present in the copper sulfate. So the zinc rod will react with the sulfate ions and will lose the electron. And the lost electrons of the zinc was gained by the copper ion. Then what happens? So that copper ion is reduced to copper. That is what these brown spots or red spots are what? Due to formation of copper there. So it is what aqueous solution, the zinc is converting into zinc sulfate. So whenever zinc sulfate is what colorless, but whereas if you are taking copper sulfate, copper is in plus 2 oxidation state, will have the blue color due to presence of unpaired electron. Okay, na? So due to this, what happens? These are all effects I observe. So in this case, what happening? The zinc is oxidized. That is increase in oxidation number 0 to plus 2. That is zinc metal is losing the electron. Whenever it lost the electron, that loss of electron is called what? Oxidation. And copper plus 2, whatever the number of electron which is lost by the zinc, those electrons are gained by the copper ion and will reduce it to copper. So it is called what? Reduction. Gain of electron is called reduction. Or plus 2 to 0, that is decrease in oxidation number, is also called reduction. Okay. So now in a single reaction, without taking any help, that reaction is proceeding. It is what? A spontaneous reaction. It is a spontaneous reaction. Without taking any help, that reaction is proceeding. And also, here what happens? So spontaneous oxidation and reduction takes place in a single reaction. So it is said to be a redox reaction. Redox reaction, and it is a spontaneous reaction. Redox and a spontaneous reaction. Is that clear? So that is what by spontaneous redox reaction, the electrons are transferring from zinc to copper. The transfer of electron is called what? Current. To identify that current, we have the electrochemical cells. Is that clear? So what are the observation and what is the effect? Okay, na? So is that clear what happens actually in electrochemical cell? So now let's get into the cells, electrochemical cells. Now here, what is mean by electrochemical cells? The cells in which electrical energy is generated by the spontaneous redox reaction. By spontaneous chemical redox reactions, what happens? Electrical energy will be developed. That is, in electrochemical cell, by spontaneous chemical reaction, electrical energy is developed. But whereas in case of electrolytic cell, the electric current is utilized for the producing the chemical reactions. Okay, na? So it is exactly reverse to that. Now here what examples for this electrochemical cell will be galvanic cell, Daniell cell and voltaic cell. Now you see here, I'm taking the two half cells. This is one electrolytic cell. So this is another electrolytic cell. These are the two electrolytic cells. So in the first electrolytic cell, I'm taking a zinc sulfate solution. So in the second electrolytic cell, I'm taking the copper sulfate solution. This copper sulfate solution, aqueous copper sulfate. It is what? Zinc sulfate, aqueous zinc sulfate solution. Okay. So now in these two electrolytic cells, so what I am doing, I am placing the respective metal rods. That is, zinc sulfate solution is dipped with the zinc rod. So it is a zinc rod. Now here in copper sulfate solution, I am placing the what? Copper rod. Okay, so it is a copper rod, it is what a zinc rod. These two metal rods are connected to the external circuit. So to identify the current flow, so we are using the ammeter, or you can use the voltmeter or ammeter, whatever it may be, you can use anything. Now in this case, what happens whenever the zinc rod is placed in zinc sulfate solution? Okay, na? So in this case, this zinc metal slowly dissolves in the electrolytic solution. So the size of the zinc rod will be slowly decreases. Then what happens? The zinc rod solid will react with whenever it is dissolving in the electrolytic solution, that is zinc sulfate solution, and will loses the what electrons. Will lose the electrons and convert it to what? Zinc plus 2 plus 2 electrons. That is what it is generating the electron. it is releasing the electron. It is acting as what? Source of electron. It is zinc rod is acting as what? Source of electron. So which act as source of electron, that electrode is said to be anode. This electrode is said to be anode, and it is which is present as anode, it is acting as what? Source of electron, that is a negative charge. Is that clear? But whereas in case of electrolytic cell, anode means positive charge. But whereas in case of electrochemical cell, anode means negative charge. Do remember that. Why I am giving here negative charge? Because here the anode is acting as source of electron. It is generating the electrons. Okay, na? So that is what anode with negative charge. Now whatever the electron which are released at this anode electrode. Now these electrons, what happens? These electrons are going towards the. These electrons are going through this circuit, external circuit, to this copper electrode. So the electrons are coming here. So then what happens? Copper sulfate contains copper ions. These copper ions, when the electrons are coming here, these copper ions gains those electrons and will deposit as copper. So here it is what? Aqueous one and copper. Now what happens? The size of the copper rod slowly increases. What is the reason to increase in size of the copper rod here? Because the whatever the copper ions which are present in the electrolytic solution, those all are depositing on the electrode. Is that clear? Now here what happens? Reduction takes place. Now it is absorbing the electrons. So it is acting as what? Source of electrons. So it is anode. It is accepting the electrons. So it is when it will accept the electron, when it is having deficiency, that is what? Plus symbol. So it acts as what? Copper rod will act as cathode. Copper rod will act as cathode, which is what absorb the electron, which is not the source of electron, which is a receiver of electron. You can call it as what? Receiver of electrons. So which receives the electron, that is said to be what? Cathode. Okay, na? At cathode what happens? Reduction reaction takes place. At anode what happening? Oxidation reaction takes place. Oxidation reaction. The respective electrodes, what type of reactions are taking place, we had discussed. Now this reaction is also, this half cell is also said to be this cell. It is what? Left side. So left side, it is one half cell, it is not the complete cell. When it is said to be complete, when we have anode and cathode in one cell, one electrolyte. Here only one electrode is there in an electrolytic cell. So it is left half cell. It is what? Left half cell. In left half cell, what happens, Amma? What happens? Oxidation takes place. So it is also called oxidation half cell. It is also called oxidation half cell. And also, it is also called what? Anodic half cell. Because at left oxidation, this left electrolytic cell, what type of reaction takes place? Oxidation reaction. So at which electrode oxidation takes place? At anode. In both electrolytic cell as well as electrochemical cell, oxidation takes place at anode only. So it is anodic half cell. Anodic half cell. So and also it is also called negative half cell. It is also called negative half cell. Is that clear? Because anodic half cell will have the which charge? Negative charge. This is what half cell of this reaction. Now in this case, this half cell is said to be, it is left half cell. It is what? Right half cell. This cathodic half cell is said to be right half cell. It is oxidation half cell. It is reduction half cell. It is reduction. It is right half cell. It is anodic half cell. It is what? Cathodic half cell. It is negative half cell. It is what? Positive half cell reaction. So these are the terms which we are using in the examination. So in sometimes they will say left half cell, oxidation half cell, anode half cell, okay, negative oxidation, negative half cell. So just a simple to remember here, lone. So what is lone? L-O-A-N. Okay, na? So left oxidation at anode, that anode will have the negative charge. In left half cell what happens? Oxidation takes place. That oxidation taking place at anode, that anode has the negative charge. Is that clear? So left, in left half cell, what happens? Oxidation takes place. That oxidation takes place at anode. That oxidation takes place at anode. That anode is present. That anode will have the negative charge. Is that clear? That is lone. Simple to remember. Anodic half cell. So similarly, so cathodic half cell RRCP. Okay, now if you remember this one, automatically you will get that one. Exactly, it is opposite one. Is that clear? Now up to here it is okay. After some time, what happens here? After some time, what happens? You see, in the electrolytic solution, all the zinc ions are increasing here because the zinc is converting into zinc plus 2 by loss of electrons. So number of zinc ions will be increases in the electrolytic solution. So all zinc ions will surround this electrode. Here number of zinc ions, all the electrons are going there. So then what happens? Number of Zn plus 2 ions are increases in the electrolytic solution. It is having plus charge. Then why it will gives the again electrons? It will not give, no. So then what happens? This prevents the flow of electron from this anode half cell to cathode half cell. When it is prevents that flow of electron from anode to cathode, then the cell reaction will stops. Now similarly, you see in this case, the electrons are coming and they are depositing the what, all the copper ions. So they are converting into copper. Then what is left over here? Sulfate ions are left over. Here the concentration of sulfate ion will be increases in the cathodic half cell. The number of sulfate ions are increases in the cathodic half cell. When the sulfate ions are increases in the cathodic half cell, so which has the negative charge? Will it allow the flow of electron inside? No, it will not allow, because already it has the negative charge. When it is have negative charge, it does not allow the flow of electron, inflow of electron. So then what happens? The reaction will stop. So what happens here? The reaction stops means, will it working as a proper? No, it is not working as a proper. Now we have to place the water here. One electrolyte we have to add to this one to neutralize the Zn plus 2 ion and to neutralize the sulfate ions. So we have to place the one salt bridge here. That is the main role of salt bridge. What we are using this salt bridge, those all we are seeing. So salt bridge, which is very very important. So what is salt bridge here? It is an inverted U-shaped tube. It is an inverted U-shaped tube. So it is called what? A salt bridge. It is called salt bridge. So that salt bridge, why we are using here? To maintain the electrical neutrality and to complete the circuit. Now you see here, this is half cell, this is half cell. They are not having any connection. Okay, now this ammeter is just used to identify flow of electron. The electrons are moving from anode to cathode. So current will move from cathode to anode. So current will move from cathode to anode. Is that clear? Now, in this case, salt bridge. Salt bridge is what? It is an inverted U-shaped tube. It is U. It is inverted means it will be like this. It is an inverted U-shaped tube which is filled with inert electrolytes. Inert electrolytes like potassium chloride, potassium sulfate, ammonium chloride, or you can take it as ammonium nitrate. So these electrolytes are what? Inert in their respective cells. Okay, na? So this, that salt bridge will be filled with this respective electrolyte. And along with these electrolytes, we have to take the agar-agar solid, agar-agar powder, agar-agar powder, or you can take it as gelatin. Gelatin. Why we have to take this one, this gelatin agar-agar solution? So here agar-agar powder or gelatin, which makes the water semi-solid liquid. So which makes semi-solid liquid. Okay, for the preparation of semi-solid liquid. So then what happens? We are using agar-agar powder or gelatin, which generates the ions in the semi-solid liquid. These are all solids. So to generate the ions, we are using this one. Okay, na? So that is what in salt bridge, what component we are taking. So what happens actually? By placing the salt bridge, what happens? Now we have, for example, we are taking this potassium chloride. So that potassium chloride, when it is present in salt bridge, when we are using in salt bridge, say for example, what happens? The chloride ions and the potassium ions. Now here, which is filled with water, this agar-agar mixture along with that potassium chloride, and we made the saturated solution with a semi-solid liquid. So then what happened? The salt bridge, to neutralize the zinc ions, this chloride ions will enter into the this anodic half cell, because here positive charge is more. But whereas here in this case what happens? Negative charge is more. Then what happens? Potassium ions are released into this. Then what happens? Salt bridge maintains electrical neutrality. It maintains the what? Electrical neutrality. What is the function of salt bridge here? Function is what? It maintains the electrical neutrality. Electrical neutrality. And after that, most important, it completes the circuit. It completes the circuit. It completes the circuit. Is that clear? It completes the circuit. So by flow of, whenever the potassium ions are coming, those potassium ions, sulfate ions are neutralized, then what happens? Again, inflow of electron will take place. Again, this chloride ions combine with Zn plus 2 ions, or combined with chloride ions, it forms the soluble chloride ion, zinc chloride. It is what? A soluble one. Now I said here, inert electrolyte. Are these inert electrolytes? In general cases, they are not inert electrolytes. They are strong electrolytes because they are salt. So what happens in this particular electrolytic cell? What happened? That potassium chloride is in that chloride ion combined with zinc ion. It is forming the soluble product. In that soluble product, so that chloride ion is not changing the concentration of this electrolytic cell. So it is not reacting with the electrolytic component, and it is not changing its chemical composition. Just what it is doing, it is maintaining the electrical neutrality. Is that clear? So here also potassium ions combine with sulfate ion. That potassium sulfate is soluble. So potassium ions, sulfate ions will be present in the soluble state. So it is not changing the concentration of electrolyte. So it is not changing its chemical composition. It is maintaining electrical neutrality in both the half cell. And one more most important function is there. It reduces liquid-liquid junction potential. Liquid-liquid junction potential. Now you see here, the galvanic cell or voltaic cell or Daniell cell, which has the water, their voltage will be 1.1 voltage. So their potential difference is what? Their potential, how much it will be developed? So 1.1 volts will be developed in this galvanic cell. Now what happens when we are, when it is 1.1 volt is, the electrode potential is equal to 1.1 volt, then what happens? The flow of electron won't take place from anode to cathode. Then the reaction will be stops. Always the potential difference should be what? Less than that 1.1 volt. Then only it acts as what? Electrochemical cell. So if it want to be less than that, then what happens here? Potassium ions are coming. Now you see in this case, I'm erasing this one. Now when these chloride ions are coming here, say for example, these chloride ions, these all chloride ions, here all zinc ions are coming. So both are what? In liquid state, plus minus. Then what happens in between the positive and negative? Some potential is developed. Okay, na? In between those two liquids, it is also liquid, aqueous, it is also liquid, in aqueous only. Okay, na? So then what happens? Some potential will be developed between these two. So then what happens? The salt bridge will reduces that potential. Say for example, initially it is 0.1 volt initially. So what happens whenever we are using that salt bridge, it is reduced to 0.01 volt or it may be 0.001 volt. So whenever it is 0.1 volt, then what happens? It is more than that. It is 1.1, it is more than 1.1, it will be reaches. Then what happens? The cell will be stops. If it is equal to 1.1 volt, the electrochemical cell will stops. If it is more than 1.1 volt, then what happens, you know? The reverse reaction takes place. That is, electrons will migrate from cathode to anode. There, at that condition, when the cell, E-cell electrode potential is more than 1.1 volts, then copper will act as anode and zinc will act as cathode. So there what happens? Copper will act as source of electron and zinc will act as what? Receiver of electron. When it is, E-cell is more than 1.1. So E-cell is what? Always electrode potential, difference in electrode potential should be less than 1.1 volt. Then what happens? The zinc will act as anode. Zinc will act as anode and copper will act as cathode. Okay na? So if you want to convert this electrochemical cell into electrolytic cell, you have to apply the more potential. Then what happens? The reverse reaction takes place. That is in case of electrolytic cell. How it will be takes place? By utilizing more potential, how it will be changes its reaction. Is that clear? So that is what most important. Here liquid-liquid junction potential is reduced. Then which reduces the water potential difference, that is less than 1.1 volt. So then what happens? The cell reaction takes place continuously in spontaneous manner. Is that clear everyone? So that are the functions of a salt bridge. And one more thing, why we have to use these only? Why not sodium chloride? Why not sodium sulfate? Why not other? We have so many electrolytes, no? Why only these? So because these electrolytes are having, so whatever the ions which are present, so those are having equal mobility. They are having the what? Mobility of ions is more. Mobility of ions is more. And also here, the cation and anion will have the equal mobility. Cation and anion will have equal mobility. Is that clear? So that is the main reason why we are using those salts only. So next we'll see some questions. Now we had seen in galvanic cell what happens. So zinc is undergoing oxidation, copper is undergoing reduction. So in galvanic cell, so zinc is converting into zinc plus 2. So copper ion is converting into copper. This we had seen, which takes place in galvanic cell. What is Daniell cell? Here salt bridge is replaced by porous pot, then it is converted Daniell cell. Okay, na? So voltaic cell also. Now in this case, what are the reaction we had seen? So it is what we are calling cell reaction. So how to represent this? How we are getting this cell reaction and cell representation, we'll see. So cell representation, very very important, cell representation. In case of galvanic cell only we'll discuss. That is, at left hand side what is there? Anodic half cell is there. Okay, so right hand side what is there? Cathodic half cell and anodic half cell is present at your left hand side. Cathodic half cell is present at the right hand side. So that anode is what it is doing? It is converting metal to metal plus 2. That is, zinc is converting into zinc plus 2. The double line indicates what? This double line indicates salt bridge. Okay. So here what happens? M plus 2 is converted to L. Is that clear? So it is oxidation. Oxidation half cell, it is what? Reduction half cell. Okay, reduction half cell should be written on your right hand side. Oxidation half cell should be written on left hand side, which are separated by salt bridge. That is double arrow. Okay, now double lines. So now you take in case of galvanic cell, in case of zinc and copper electrode, electrolytic cell, there what happens? Zinc is converted to zinc plus 2. So it is a cell representation of galvanic cell. So copper plus 2 is reduced to copper. In case of, if you are taking in case of nickel and silver electrode. So many electrode. Most important is what? Zinc and copper. In every CBSE or NCERT books, they mention zinc and copper. So we may get the chance of questions getting on nickel and silver electrode also. You can take here what happens. Nickel is converted to nickel plus 2. Is act as anode, anodic half cell. So silver ions will gain the electron, will convert it to silver. And also you can take chromium and lead electrode. Chromium and lead electrode. Chromium will be converted to Cr plus 3. So lead is changes to Pb plus 2 to Pb. So these are the cell representation of different electrolytic cells, electrochemical cells. Is that clear? Now this is cell representation. Now we are going to see the cell reaction. How to write cell reaction? Cell reactions are very important. So they will give that cell representation they will give. So how to write from that, from the cell representation, how to write cell reaction? So cell reaction does not include the electrons. That you need to focus. Cell reaction should not include the electrons. Say for example, first we will take zinc and copper electrode. So zinc contains, zinc will undergo in oxidation, that is zinc plus 2 electron. So that is anodic half cell takes place oxidation. And cathodic half cell, what happens? So that copper ion will gain the 2 electron, will convert it to copper. So whenever we are adding, so these 2 electron will be cancelled out. And we add the left side electrodes, right side you should add. So copper plus 2, it is aqueous. It is also aqueous, it is also aqueous. Now here it is a solid. Now copper solid plus zinc plus 2 aqueous. This is what cell reaction of the zinc and copper electrode. You can take another example, that is nickel and silver. Nickel and silver. Here what happens? Nickel is converted to, I had written now, nickel to nickel plus 2. So salt bridge. Ag plus 2, Ag plus 2, Ag. Now in this case, which is oxidation half cell? This one. That is nickel is converted to nickel plus 2 by loss of 2 electron. So silver is converted to silver metal. Here aqueous, it is solid. Here it is aqueous, it is solid. Now it is converting into water silver by gain of electron. Now you see here 2 electrons are there. To cancel that electron, I have to multiply this reduction half reaction with the 2. Then what happens? 2 Ag plus 2 electron plus 2 Ag. Then what happens if you add these 2? 2 electron, 2 electron get cancelled. So nickel plus 2 Ag plus gives rise to nickel plus 2 plus 2 Ag. This is the cell representation. Very, very important cell representation. If you don't know the representation of cell, you cannot do the problems on this. Now here work is what here for you? Chromium lead electrode. So for this you write the cell representation. That is chromium to chromium plus 3, salt bridge, Pb plus 2 to Pb. So for this reaction you write the cell representation. Is that clear? So this is what electrochemical cell completely I had explained. From this you won't miss even a single question also. Each and every concept I had explained with example sums also. These are the example sums which are very helpful for doing the calculation part. I think so you have enjoyed a lot. So keep watching Appa Chemistry classes. Thank you. Have a nice day. Keep learning.